guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Sabrina. Today we are talking about top 11 jobs, top 11 most well-paid jobs in the United States. So if you are interested who earns $30,000 a month, please continue watching this video. As you know, and if you do not know, then you should subscribe to my channel, USA Videos. And this video is about the amount of money that the people earn. Our profession number 11 is called software engineer, obvious, right? You have to have computer science degree and you have to be good at coding. If you come to San Francisco, you have the majority of job openings. And currently, there are more than 1,000 job openings. And people earn around $110,000 a year. Profession number 10, coverage controller, this guy manage corporate finance. They do tax optimization. They do different things or control the financials of a big corporation. You should have a background in finance, I would say. Maybe you have like a bachelor degree from your country, but if you want to be a corporate controller, I would suggest doing master's in finance here in the United States. So you know the standards that are here and you would get acquainted with the corporate culture of America. And as you know, if you're a foreign student, if you have come to the States, do your master's, you get up to 3 years of opt, which is a work for you to stay in the United States and work for this period of time. So yeah, if you have a master's degree in finance, you can totally apply for a corporate controller position. And there are currently 259 job openings for the corporate controller, and the majority of them are concentrated in New York. And as you know, New York is the financial center of the United States. For a city, Wall Street, everything is there. Like if we were talking about tech and innovation and code and whatever, San Francisco, Silicon Valley, and in San Francisco right now, by the way, we are talking about finance and maybe like fashion, that's New York. And if we're talking about usually racial social media or bloggers or light film, well, I'm going to ask as a profession number 9, R&D manager. These guys are responsible for innovation and research right now. A lot of money go into research and development in medical sphere. I have a couple of friends here who actually working on like beating cancer or trying to grow organ in pigs so they can be transplanted in human beings later. And like this pair is really well financed, and yes, people are looking for cure for different diseases. So if you have a medical background and if you're into research, this is something you can totally do. As you know, you do PhD in United States and majority of PhDs receive full financial assistance, and yet your studies will be financed. You will get some step and you will work on your research, and yeah, when you graduate, you can be an R&D manager. You will earn around $110,000 a year. Currently, there are around 200 job openings. Number 8, applications development manager. This is the guy who actually manages the creation of different applications. We can talk about apps on our phones. We can talk about the apps on desktop, but this is a guy who would manage different people involved in creating an application. Link designers, UX, UIs, product managers, and developers themselves. You would need a computer science degree or background in computer science in order to apply for this job. And again, the majority of job offerings are in Texas. You know why Texas is called the new Silicon Valley here? In the United States, I totally understand why, because rent here, like in San Francisco, crazy salaries are crazy. And you have to compete with companies like Google and Facebook who offer you. No, an intern at Facebook earns $7,000 a month. Like seriously, the guy who just graduated from, his second year of his bachelor earns $7,000. Say, it's really impossible to compete with other employees here. So a lot of companies are transferring their development officers into Texas, and Texas is growing into that sense. Application development managers can earn around $112,000 a year, and there are more than 500 job openings right now. And maybe as one, you want this disclaimer, I wouldn't select my profession just based on how much people earn or how much job openings there are. I would choose it based on whatever I love. You should ask yourself, what is that thing that I'm able to do for free for the next 2 years? And if the answer is like, well, games on computer, then you should study a switch favorite channel and make money off it. And if it's video, then you should start using just at your own YouTube channel. So you shouldn't be like, oh my god, application managers are in so much money, I should be an application manager. Like, seriously? Number 7, physician's assistant. And we are coming into medical. Lovely medical field where people spend hundreds of thousands of dollars in their education, and they can just have to earn a lot in order to pay off all their debt. And this is why medicine like healthcare in the United States is so expensive. And as I said, a lot is being done in order to improve the situation. But physician assistants earn $112,000 a year. And this is not even doctor. This is somebody who just helps. He is not able to like consult patients yet. And again, they earn. And he's gonna work with C-level managers, and they're gonna decide what's the best way. How do we optimize all the IT resources that we have in order to grow faster? And of course, you should have computer science background to apply for this position. I would suggest having like at least 2 or 3 years of experience, because you would need to know how everything works from inside out. The average salary is $112,000 a year, and there are more than 1300 job openings for this position, and the majority of them are in New York. A lot of IT businesses are also moving to New York if they're connected with like fashion or finance, because this is the place where they find partners. So I would say, if you are a developer looking for job openings in San Francisco of Silicon Valley and New York as well as Texas. Number 5, again, medicine. What I am singing, pharmacist. A guy who worked in a pharmacy earned $125,000 a year, and 1 in 5,000 job open right now on Glassdoor. Guys, how much do pharmacists earn in your country? But in my country, where I come from, nothing close to this. Again, healthcare in the United States is really expensive. There are a lot of job openings for this position. And Baltimore, which is the hometown for Johns Hopkins, the university, which is one of the best medical science. And California, San Diego, oh my god, this word again. Liaison, liaison number for medical science. Liaison, this is the guy that sits down with our CEO of the clinic, and they decide together what inventory they are gonna buy, which market have the most opportunity for them. Do they market this and this that product? So this is I would say, who has a background in medicine and background in economics. And if you remember, one of my master's application was to carry business school in Johns Hopkins. And I would say, this is one of the best school for like combining both disciplines, because Johns Hopkins is a really good university for medicine. And the carry business school has a lot of masters like marketing in medicine or research in medicine. So if you are interested someone like this, I would consider Johns Hopkins another place to consider for medical studies. Of course, have at the topmost medical school in the United States. These guys earn $132,000 a year, and they're around 1400 job openings right now, and the majority of them are concentrated in Cambridge, exactly where Harvard is. Cambridge Max Lasers already. So we are at the top 3 most well-paid jobs in the United States. Number 3, of course, it should be that one course that connected with law, because lawyers here earn a lot of money. You wouldn't believe, like, we registered a company, we have this lawyer, and her rate is $950 an hour. An hour, like talking to her for an hour, $950. I know the majority of that would be taken by the company itself to support like other people who work in the office. But yes, they earn a lot of number. 3 is patent attorney. This is the guy who would help you with trademark patent. It would represent you in court. If you have any problems, who would help you register it? Guys earn around $140,000 a year, and there are more than 500 job openings right now. The majority of them are in Los Angeles. In order to become a lawyer in the United States, you would need to know, have a background in law. Funny, right? But if you have a background in law from in your country, if you come to the state, I was just doing an LLM, which is a 1-year law degree. And you should a bar exam, and you will become an accredited attorney in the state where you pass the bar exam. If you don't have a background in law, but many Americans do, you a GD program, which is a 3-year program. You have to assess all set to be accepted, but then at the end of the program again you passed the bar exam and you became a licensed attorney number 2. Pharmacy manager and pharmacy managers are around $150,000 in the United States. Majority of 2,370 job openings are concentrated again in the Texas. And yeah, you should have a medical science background. I was just managing background again. John Sims has perfect master's degree for that. And number one, like, I wouldn't be surprised, but so physician doctors, they earn $130,000 a year, which is the average across all over the different specifications across the states. And there are more than 7,000 job openings, so doctors are in high demand. But this is where Glassdoor stops, and they say yes, this is the first paid job in the United States. But I went farther, because there are so many different doctors. Made my research, and here it is. If you are a surgeon, on average you earn $338,000 a year. Now we go up. If you are an anesthesiologist, and this Caesar anesthesiologist, you earn $350,000 a year. You radiologist, $355,000 a year. And number one, please pay attention, cardiologist, $356,000 a year. Let's see what's their per month. P56 divided by 12, $30,000. If you are a cardiologist, okay. So highest tax rate in United States is 40%. So even if you pay like 40% in Texas, which they don't like normally, you'd have a mortgage. You wouldn't have like children or dependent people. So this will minimize your tax. But on average, they will get like $80,000 anymore after it lags. Ow, ow, ow. Like, I was sitting with a guy here. I am in the office and there was one guy here. He was listening to me. And he just closed his laptop and said, I am gonna get my medical degree. I am like, those people can definitely start living in San Francisco. They do. I would say, like, because this is the average salary, I would say our cardiologists earn more than that in San Francisco. San Francisco is an expensive city, and this is averaged by like Texas, which is less expensive state. I hope I surprised you guys. Please do not forget to subscribe to this channel and like this video if you're still watching. Like, if you are not in coma after hearing all of this zero salaries here in the United States, please like this video. If you enjoyed it, let me know. Thank you so much for watching this up to the end. I will see you next week. Bye bye.